this is the closest I can come to saying what I've learned. There's no shortage of consequence in my life. We need to leave some evidence. A little of us everywhere. I spent all my time staring in one direction, and I missed it. The most important moments were in the edges. There were 7 of them.
Comrade?
Yeah.
You're gonna have to drive.
You know, you're really bleeding.
Get in the car. Come on. Hit a deer on the way here. Clipped her, really. She went flying head first into a snowdrift. Wasn't breathing, so I took the defibrillator over to her. Next thing I know, she's wide awake and she kicks me in the face. Jesus.
You're bleeding pretty badly. You sure you don't want me to take you to a hospital?
No, I'm taking some Percodan. I can hardly feel any of this.
There's a lot of blood.
You got your own burden. Mother being found after all these years. Well, I hope we have enough you can ID her.
All I need are the teeth.
Yeah, we should have those. Cleared out the freezer and put her parts in there. Everyone from the station got to take some venison home.
Guess you folks don't get a lot of crime up here, huh?
No, sir. Especially murder. Not until we found this body. We didn't think that he literally killed her. Speaking of your father, your aunt thinks maybe you've been talking about him.
I haven't seen my father since I left the farm.
Seems a tricky word. No contact at all?
No.
If you have been talking to him and you don't tell us about it, that could be considered accessory after the fact. Conrad, don't worry about it. It's just a cut.
It's terrible.
You're making a mountain out of a molehill.
I told him to go.
Oh my gosh, are you okay?
Yeah. Oh, God. It's okay. It's okay. I'm okay. Don't help me. I don't want help.
Right, I've been patched up. Do you mind staying here and holding down the fort? It's just the two of us and a deputy who's been on duty since yesterday. You know, everyone and their dog is sliding off the road.
You want me to stay here, Will?
Yes. I know it's weird, but...
Okay.
Okay, thanks. Okay, come on, you.
No.
I'm taking you to the hospital.
I've got work to do.
You really need to go.
I'll win. I'm strong. Come
okay.
on.
Sorry about this, Conrad.
Thanks.
No pleasure.
You hungry? Sheriff was supposed to put you up tonight, but he's in no real position to entertain.
Was there a motel?
Chapman? Kind of stuck with me. I'm on duty for the next few hours, so. Deputy found some new evidence. Murder weapon? Not about 6 feet from bones. It says a handle will shoot up. Look like an animal had dragged it all about.
Sawed off shotgun.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I looked in the freezer. It's not my mother.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Her teeth were a mess. It's not her.
I mean, who could it be then? We don't just have people unaccounted for.
It's my father.
Who would have wanted to kill your father?
Himself.
This happens a lot this time of year. I can't believe I only have one blanket. Jeez.
Day could not get any weirder.
What was she like? Your mother?
She would never leave me alone with my father for more than 2 seconds.
Do you think maybe she's still alive?
No. I don't have any hope of that.
Oh.
You want to hear something?
Okay.
About 4 weeks after she disappeared, my father took me on a walk to the top of the woods.
Yourself. Get up or you'll freeze to the stump. Get in home. Best hurry up.
Stove. Told me to stand by it. And he waited the whole time it took for me to thaw out. And in the morning he was gone. I never saw him again.
It must be so terrible for you to be back here. I'm so sorry.
No, I feel better about it now.
Did you know he's dead?
Knowing that he intended to include himself makes it less personal.
It all started when my family moved from Illinois to New Mexico.
Stop it. How many times have I told you that? Cover your eyes. Stop it.
Is Dad gonna pick me up after school?
No, you're gonna walk home.
Mom?
Our doctor insisted we move to a warmer climate for the sake of my father. I remember not knowing what to do, but knowing that I wanted to be the least of their worries. And then I saw him. All I could remember on my first day of school was the menacing look he had on his face. His name was Bobby Bell.
Bounces twice, but you can't hit it before it bounces, and you can't let it double bounce or you're out. Okay.
Sounds simple enough? Right?
Yeah, I guess.
So, where are you from?
Chicago.
Chicago? What's your favorite food?
Anything, I guess, really.
Tacos?
Yes.
Yeah, the rest of the game, though, you have to stand right here against the wall, but you can't move. You can't move.
Stay still.
Stay.
just like this? I thought, am I supposed to dodge it?
No, just...
You're doing great, Paul.
Yeah.
Just don't move.
New Mexico Outlaws back. How was your first day at school?
Make any new friends?
Well, it's okay if you didn't. I didn't make any my first year either.
I was just asking. Did you, honey?
Yeah. Are you gonna lose all your hair?
What?
In my book, it says when you have this disease, you could lose all your hair.
Wait, you're a doctor now. Let's have a look. Don't read books like this.
As months went by, I remember trying to do something, anything. Whatever I could do to help my father win his fight. And suddenly, like a disease, word spread around school.
Say the Cubs could go all the way this year. All the way. I've been thinking about this disease. It's like a bunch of uninvited guests. You didn't ask them to come. They just showed up one day and didn't go home. You want to explain yourself? This
fight that I am having is mine. You understand?
This fight was also mine. I'm much older now, and a part of me is still in that bed beside him. The other part back on that playground, hoping that fight put me back together again.
Without stopping. In the First World War, pelicans transported supplies across enemy lines.
Amanda peeled labels, chewed nails, ate the caps off pens. Twice she tried to kill herself. I used to think we'd be best friends forever and not just sisters. That was before Dad died. Before she went to rehab for the third time. Before I moved far away from the mess I used to call home.
Hey, you know, we were invited over to Timmy's later.
I do know. What? I talked to him. It's my ex-boyfriend.
Yeah, after he was mine.
I have no problem with leftovers. It doesn't even make any sense saying I drink like a fish. It's like saying I read like a worm.
Amanda, who said you drink like a fish? Mom just said you shouldn't drive.
Mom said I shouldn't drive. You know what? You're more like the fish.
I'm ignoring that.
Come on. You're being a haddock, like a smoked haddock, you know?
I've been home for like an hour. Can we just have a normal conversation, please?
Sorry.
Does anybody want a Muddy Mary? With some leaves on top?
Oh, you know what we should do? We should go inside and get a cognac. That is the perfect dusk drink.
Don't you think you should just slow down a little bit?
Why? Celebrating my sister's annual abbreviated trip to the homeland.
Okay, well, the sun doesn't go down for another 3 hours.
Yeah, but if you get started early, anything's possible. You of all people should know that, Lisa. The combined IQ of a colony of ants exceeds the intellect of most U.S. senators.
My mother.
They wish to eat me.
One drink made her Queen Victoria, and three took her out of it.
Was under the impression that Amanda liked margaritas, loved margaritas.
Counting his cock, what me and Amanda used to call our stepfather self-fondling.
What are we gonna do with all of these margaritas? I was under the impression, sweetie, that Amanda liked margaritas.
We heard you already. Okay. Go find your sister.
Sweetie, go see where she is, okay? Oh. Huh? Thank you. What the hell are you gonna do with the rest of me?
An ant is attracted to the genitals of all mammals, both male and female.
Don't point at me. My mother's not dead. What? We know what? What? I'm ready. With the glass, okay?
Hey. Seriously, you're acting and you made me drag you all the way in here?
Stripped of its stinger, a bee becomes nothing more than a raisin with wings.
You ever notice that there's no street lights in this town that work? You still work at that delivery place?
Yes. Yes, that's what I'm doing. No, actually, I quit that 3 years ago. Do you know anything about me, what I'm doing, anything at all?
Okay. Let's don't.
I work at a dock, and I manage a band.
Have I heard of them?
Do you listen to any decent bands? I wanted to do some more artistic stuff, so I decided to become a monologuist.
Is that like a comic?
No, it's like performance art, you know? So I would tell stories about my life, and I would incorporate facts about animals and then sort of do this.
Ah, inspiring.
kept trying to push the show and push. Just hoping eventually that somebody would get what I was going for. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I have a kind of idea of the man I want, but fucking clowns I meet are never anywhere close.
The stingerless bee becomes an outcast and must make its way in a world alone.
Thinness is genetic, like baldness.
Unless you're me, and then you're really skinny. But that's because you never eat, right? Look at that. Look at it. You wanna put your little nose in there? You wanna put your little nose in there? There, put your little nose in it. I like your hair. Don't listen to my sister.
Do you have any drinking beverages in here?
A pelican can fly 3,000 miles without stopping. In the First World War, pelicans were used to transport supplies against enemy lines. The combined IQ of a colony of ants exceeds that of the intelligence of most U.S. senators. My sister and I went to see the famous monkeys at the St. Louis Zoo.
What famous monkeys?
And the monkeys shared a tale. You couldn't tell where the first monkey ended, and the next monkey began.
I forgot how many signs we had. The hand signal that indicated someone was lying. The nostril flare that meant we were dealing with a loser. The hiccup that said, let's get the hell out of here.
Third monkey who went into the kitchen to get the first monkey a drink. Father crashed into a tree. And Monkey One and Monkey Two dived into the magic bottle. And Monkey One transformed into a bird. And Monkey Two transformed into a fish. When they spoke to each other, neither of them could understand what each other was saying anymore. What do you think? You're prettier than I am. Yeah. Thank you.
Hi. I'm Monica.
Mr. Chubb, may I see your driver's license?
Why? You get a lot of strange women pretending to be maids? Usually I don't mind being carded, but not at work.
Please, come in. Come on, please. Well, I have my own vacuum.
Nice condo. He could be an agent. It always pays to wear lipstick.
So, Monica, did you bathe this morning?
Seriously? 9 a.m., and he's already pictured me naked.
Oh, I want you. You won't be sorry.
No. You're my employer. We should keep it that way. Besides, I don't think my boyfriend would like it very much. What? You don't have the right to ask me that.
I didn't mean to offend. I just have a thing about cleanliness.
So I noticed. His hair is kind of nappy, though. I mean, natty. Natty is not a racist word, is it? I dated a black guy once.
I'm just like... Thank you.
Wow. Ever think about knocking?
I didn't mean to startle you.
Well, you did.
You work very intently. Call if you need me.
I'm fine, thank you.
Have you forgotten the way to El Paso? I'm doing all right, really. I know you heard they cut that lump that I had that you didn't even know about, which is why I'm writing, because I know some dumb somebody told you. My own way of telling you would have been more fun for both of us. Anyway, it's out. And there's this little cute little cut like a smiley face under my nipple. You like it.
Come see the girl who loves you no matter what. Hear me? Don't step on my heart. You're only one, Miss Famous. Of course, I'll change all the names. You don't have to get permission to do that, do you?
God, I am such a fan of your writing.
Hey, take it easy.
You bring your lunch here often?
Please don't sit down.
I used to.
What's your name?
It's not really important.
But I can guess your nickname. Foxy.
Why do these banker types always hit on me?
Wrong. It's Sting, actually.
Sting? Your nickname is Sting?
I bet I know your nickname.
Poophead? Asshole? Jerkoff?
What?
Never mind.
She must like the Police, the band, because of the lead singer.
Oh my God, that is gross.
I guess they're not a band anymore.
Not for like 30 years.
Last guy who called me Sting stepped on my heart.
That's too bad. You know, I've seen you here before. I've actually been looking for you.
You know I've been looking for you for months.
Here I am.
Thank God your book came out. Your publisher gave me your number.
Oh, I shouldn't have done that.
Sweet Monica. Will you marry me?
Fitz.
Did you say he broke your heart?
Huh?
You said the guy who broke your heart.
I didn't say he broke it, I said he stepped on it.
You have a resilient heart. I like that. I like that a lot. Excuse me. Hello? I gotta bounce. Okay, yeah. I'll see you around, Foxy. Yeah, no, he called me.
Time for a break.
I just started.
The way you dust, you deserve one.
Here we go again.
Only my Vincent makes his mother happy with a grandchild.
Nine boys, one grandchild.
But my Vincent, he names his daughter Collada, which you may not know, but my name is Collada. He names her after his mother, my Vincent.
You've told me that a million times. Do you have any new pictures?
Well, you'd think that wife of his would know I'd want new pictures every week, but she's too busy getting famous. I'm gonna be a famous model, she says. To listen to her talk, the babysitter back for years. Oh, maybe you haven't seen this one.
I bet I have.
There's my girl.
Sweetie, it's time for dinner.
I wanna keep playing.
Let's let her play.
So, has that Brian come to his senses yet? Has he come rushing to you with an armful of roses?
Haven't heard a word. But I'm sure I will, as soon as his wife pops that kid out. Younger than I am. Horrible laugh, but she sure knew how to trap him. Probably wasn't even on the pill. I will not go to him. He has to come to me.
You're late again.
Sorry.
She had a nap.
After the book comes out, Sally will need a private tutor. I'll be making appearances all over the world.
Turkey or bologna?
Bologna.
I'll start writing it soon. I'll describe his spotless condo, the way he walked, the way his little voice rode the air, the mysterious woman from El Paso, and especially his shirts, the way they face the same direction, one after another, like promises kept, like the days of a life.
Sure, I can tell you a story. There once was a very beautiful young woman named Cinderella, and she lived in a castle, I think. And she lived with her very evil stepmom and her two or three mean stepsisters. And she had to clean the house every single day, top to bottom. And then one day there was an announcement on TV that said there was gonna be a big ball, and she really wanted to go. Because she knew that the man she was supposed to be with was gonna be there. And she knew that if she went there, she would live happily ever after and be a very famous writer.
Don't you need a truck for your business?
Lazy doesn't like anything.
Stop that. Call the caddy, please.
Paul, would you help me in the kitchen, please? Laura brought us home from the hospital.
Oh, did she?
She had the boy with her.
That boy looks exactly like you.
The boy's not my boy.
We know that.
That kid is the spitting...
Spitting image.
Not in the house. There's blankets and sheets on the couch and shower. I can smell the wood lacquer on your skin.
Stop it.
Thank you.
just like me, not long for the world.
No, she needs a little bit of love, that's all. Just a little bit of love. Watch this. Here I go. See that? Well, did she not ready to leave me yet? What's Mom make of all that smoking stuff?
I don't know.
I read something a couple weeks ago. There's a doctor saying that they're actually very good for you, especially if you've had strokes and stuff.
That's perfect. I'm going to remember that.
Good.
Yeah.
How's work?
I quit the paper.
Why? You're a good writer.
Yeah, I make furniture full time now.
Well, you always like wood.
But Mom didn't tell you that?
She didn't tell me a goddamn thing. But she told me that. I knew you would make that turn.
What do you mean? No, you said go anywhere. I don't care. We can go anywhere.
You can't keep away from her.
What are you talking about? Oh, look, hey. No, I didn't even notice this was her street. I don't.
Well, Lavelle, you don't notice most things.
Oh, I don't notice most things. Mm. Isn't that interesting? Mm.
You see, he looks just like you when you were young.
Yeah. Well, the kid's not my kid.
Look at him.
What am I gonna look at him for? Hey, listen. That's not my son. That's not my son. I don't know why you don't get that. Why am I gonna look at him? That's not my son. What a dumb thing to say.
Did he smoke?
Yeah, I didn't see any point in trying to keep him from it. We drove past Laura's house. How's she doing these days?
She thinks of herself as family, coming to the hospital and everything.
You know, I don't know how you put up with that every day. He's so rude. He doesn't know he's being rude. He drives around saying shit to
your people. Father has always been a little mean. It's all he's got left. I can't deny him the one thing that he can still feel.
I mean, I don't remember any meanness in him.
I'm glad you feel that way. I don't have a particular hole in my memory. Everyone has a little meanness in them. You should see the child. I know. He's not your son. But she was your wife.
She was my wife. Mm-hmm. Right? She led me to believe we were going to get back together for 4 months and just never bothered to say, I'm pregnant.
Sometimes, honey, people can't speak their thoughts. Other words come out instead.
Go see them.
Cool. No.
grass.
You coming to see me or him?
You look like yourself.
I suppose that's a compliment.
What are you up to these days?
I'm a teller at the bank, but mostly I take care of Cliff. And, you?
I make furniture now, you know. Business is improving. I don't know, eventually there might be some money in it, but I'm happier around the lumber.
I remember you always used to say that wood can't be forced. You have to discover the form within.
Yeah, I said that bullshit, but if I did, it was probably just to impress you.
You did.
Hey, buddy. How old are you? You're a big boy. You like horses? Huh? You can have them if you want them.
Hey, honey. You want to run inside and show Grandma your new toy? Mommy's gonna talk to her friend. That was kind of you. You're still driving the swinger.
My dad loves it. I let him smoke in it. He's not himself anymore, you know. Sometimes he looks like my father, occasionally sounds like my father, but he's
I thought it would be too strange to send you pictures. I had a fling. He looked like you.
I guess I should go.
You know where to find us.
Yeah. Yourself. I want to say you look like my fucking girl, man. Stupid ass idiot. Then what? Then what? Then what? I don't know.
We were locked out. We'd have to make a decision soon. Break in or hike a few miles back to town. But for now, we were teenage boys with one concern.
A couple summers ago, I was at a church camp. And you know how they have, like, each day you've got a different activity? Well, this particular day, it was arts and crafts. And, I mean, I wasn't into it. You know, I hate fucking
You
crafts.
Hate arts and crafts?
Yeah. So this girl, you know, I kind of see her looking at me, and she was beautiful. I mean, she had, like, this perfectly feathered hair. And she had the most incredible singing voice. She could have had a record deal. That's what I told her. And so I was talking to her, and we're supposed to be making those God's eyes with the yarn or whatever. And I was like, hey, you know, you want to get out of here? She's like, okay.
I can see
so
it.
I said, come with me. And we just start making out. You know, it's like, I'm telling you, it's those innocent girls that, you know, they get the craziest.
Crazy.
Yeah, no, yeah. It's not. Just like all repressed inside or something. And her ass, oh my God. Her ass was so round. It was like the most perfectly round thing that you've ever seen.
Like a bubble?
I didn't even know nature could create something.
Damn it, Michael.
It was like a baby's head.
Oh yeah, real soft. Like
yeah, yeah,
cheeks.
Just like two
like
little
baby's
heads.
It goes without saying that this was bullshit. Lee was starving for information about sex, just like the rest of us.
That's what happened.
A few years back, Lee's father was caught performing an abortion and stripped of his license to operate. Lee didn't touch or comfort his father. He didn't ask about the law or justice or even who the woman was. He only asked one thing.
Was she naked? She was such good pussy, man. What about you, Greg?
Well, I wasn't quite as innocent as,
you get ready for the bullshit.
Camp. Hey, so, I'm out on the lawn, and it's my neighbor's yard. She was probably, like, maybe 40-something, I'm not sure, but she wasn't too old, but just right. And so she comes out, like, halfway through, all right, and she invites me in for, Twinkies and Lemonade.
Your neighbor?
It's like...
Twinkies and Lemonade?
She must have known, I don't know, but she got me. And next thing I know... She comes back around, Twinkies, Lemonade, no shirt, no bra. Just tits, man. They were like, if I had to compare them, I would probably say, like, you ain't working with, like, maybe, like, a mango, you know what I'm saying? Like, a mango. Almost like, you know how, like, when you're checking the mango to make sure it's not, like, rotten, but it's squishy and stuff, you know?
Yeah,
it was
yeah,
like a
yeah,
rotten
yeah.
mango. So, anyway, you know, I, of course, the Twinkies and Lemonade are long gone. Fuck that. And so I'm fucking her, and she starts making this noise. And damn it, if I had a tape recorder for that noise. It was beautiful.
Well, what was it?
Yeah. It was a damn serenade of beauty.
I want to hear the noise.
I wish I could create it. It was...
Yeah, you can. Go ahead. Come on.
Yeah, no, I can't,
make
man.
The noise.
I can't.
Was it a little bit like... yeah, like fucking a retarded pig, kind of?
No. It was like... You know what? All right, for y'all's sakes, okay? I'll make the noise, all right? One time show.
Yeah, okay. Yes.
Please take it in. I might not do it justice, but I'll give it a shot, okay? So, yeah, you know, right here, in here. It's like that. It's just like, it's real long and deep, like.
I thought this was the sound that she made, not you.
Oh, no, that's the sound she made, yeah.
That's the sound she made? That's the sound she made.
In fact, Greg was borrowing details from something he'd witnessed through a keyhole one night.
Over here.
Greg's parents had invited some of their friends over. They did this from time to time, apparently.
Some of that.
First.
Oh, I'm first.
That's well done,
bitch. Yeah, man. That's righteous. Hot. Thank you. Yeah. No big deal. Just. Stuff. What about you, man? What about your lady,
yeah,
Michael?
Come on.
Throwing
little
pot,
his dick wet.
Huh? Yeah.
I want to hear some dirty shit. Okay, there's this one time.
Yeah. Mm.
Let's hear it.
Yep. Ready for it.
You remember the Chandler game?
Yeah.
Well, the party. The party after the game.
You weren't there, but I went with my older brother, and it was all older chicks there, you know. And anyway, I was at this party, and I look across the room, and I see this girl. You know, I was sitting all the way across the room, but somehow we still just keep locking eyes. And she's giving me this real intense stare. She was so beautiful, man. I mean, like, movie star eyes, and she's wearing this really cute outfit. I glance down, and I see she's got these white panties on.
So what about the white panties?
So she found a way to show them to me. Just me.
Damn.
But I mean, like, did she do anything
about
it?
Like, where are you going?
The story I told my friends was only partly true. The white flash of the girl's underwear did something to me. I had to move, say something.
So what'd you do?
Well, I stand up,
okay,
and I just go straight across the room. I could tell she wanted me to do something, so I reached out.
Oh, really? What did you reach out for?
Well, I put my finger there.
Where? Where'd you put it?
Put it there. Right fucking there. Right there.
What happened from there?
Just leave us sitting. Come on.
All right. Okay.
I'll get to that. Tell us. I'd love to hear it.
Because I was a virgin, I couldn't describe what I did with the girl. What I described was a landscape. Mountains.
She gets me undressed.
Fields.
She gets undressed.
The things around me. I substituted the body of a woman for the body of the earth. At least that's what I think I did. We didn't exactly know what we were saying, but we knew we were saying more than what was said.
And she wants it, so... But you are already there. So I give it to her. You know, I give it to her real hard, you know, real fast, deep, you know. I don't think I could have got deeper or gone harder.
Oh, that's the best.
You.
Yeah. And when it was all over, I just looked at her. And then I left.
Good story, man. Yeah, come on, man, that was great.
Yeah, look at us.
Yeah.
You guys want to sing it?
Yeah, about time for me.
We talked into the night. Eventually, we did hike the 5 miles back into town to call a locksmith. But for now, we were content to sit and smoke. Three boys of no particular distinction, elevating as best we could the fragile faith that our lives had meaning.
As much as anything ever really happens, this really did. I guess you could say I was in that drifting phase. You can call it whatever you want. Somewhere between dropping out of college and the beginning of settling down. I was headed home for the summer, straightened myself out, but took a detour. A couple thousand miles west of my intended destination. I ended up at this house in Apex, Colorado. My buddy Cleet was there. Said he knew this girl that was dog sitting for some rich folks spending the summer in Scotland or something.
What's up, man?
horrible summer.
It was actually hard to tell who did and who didn't on any particular day. You know, I can't remember a lot of their names. Doesn't matter. Well, there was Barnett.
Because she fucking squats when she fucking pees.
You know, Barnett was a special kind of asshole. You know the type.
Hey, my man.
Seems bad to say, considering, that's the truth.
I don't know if I like white women anymore. I don't even know which one to pick right now, you know what I'm saying? I was thinking about that when I was throwing rocks today at a river. So anyway, I'd love to talk to you about it more if you got some time. Good shit.
Always. The baby wildebeest, okay? The retarded zebra, the gimpy little antelope. Now, based on this evidence, what do you think this movie is called? Lion, the noble beast. Still talking about that fucking movie? It's a documentary, and it's significant.
Clee was full of useful information from public television.
For you, take them and trip in good health.
The cultural importance of baseball, or the healing powers of magic mushrooms, or the most effective methods of hunting in the desert. See, those were the topics of conversation that summer, and everyone was engaged in a horse race for the dog sitter. Lyle.
You looking for something?
Yeah, just some water.
You're in the wrong place, buddy. Whiskey and ice. It's my specialty. Plus, it's all we got left, so.
Yachty! Fuck!
Stu. Nice guy. Had a flair for the near overdose.
What's up with him?
Been like that for hours. We don't know if it's drugs or something.
Or something? What do you mean, or something?
I don't know
anything. Wait for it! Won't work! Two.
Bastards.
I think we're all bastards and saints. Just depends on the day.
Quite profound for someone from Ohio.
The way I saw it, I had two options. I could turn tail, head for home, or I could throw my hat in the ring. I mean, what would you do?
This is a swampy out of nowhere.
You can't just sit next to a girl and expect her to unfold her life to you like it's a shirt she's asking you to wear. You have to show her that you're giving something up in order to talk to her. I'm telling you, man. If you want to get to the really good stories,
high school,
you have to make an effort.
The lady friend.
What do you want to know?
Wait, I want to know it all.
She wasn't especially beautiful, but she was amazing to talk to.
So you never saw her again?
I kind of lost track of her. But I did see her, yeah, at our 10-year reunion. Mm. Yeah.
You had your 10-year reunion.
Yeah, I did. Why?
No reason. I don't. I don't.
Okay. Anyway, she's married to some guy who worked for NASA.
Fuck.
Yeah. They already had a kid.
No.
Yeah, and another one on the way.
Wow.
Yeah, the whole time I kept thinking about how crazy she used to be for me, you know?
Yeah.
How it could have been my kid calling me daddy. Like somehow I'd given up my chance to walk on the moon.
It's not too late, you know, to walk on the moon.
Nah, I hate flying. Always have.
Oh, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Oh, fuck you! Fuck you!
Fuck!
That's fun. We get 5 cents for each of these. Right, help me collect them. What happened to him?
Call for the other one.
Okay. You coming?
We can't just leave him out here.
We'll wake him up. Jesus Christ. You damage your bladder holding your pee that long.
Fucking now what?
You're on the right track, just maybe thinking a little too small.
Fuckhead. Come here, grab his arms. I got an idea.
Oh, shit. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Right. Well deserved bath here. It's some consolation that he was an asshole, but what are you gonna tell Lila?
Nothing. We're not telling Lila anything.
I can't believe this. Who dies?
Could you not say it like that?
Like what?
Of all the days to run out of fucking alcohol.
Did you check his pulse?
Don't tell Stu. Don't fucking tell anyone.
I think Lila had any second thoughts about being my girlfriend. I didn't. But you know how it is. You fall in love, you can't see beyond it. I guess that's where time, it just gets away from you. Is that shit or vomit?
This is damnation territory.
I may have had something to do with that.
Should somebody maybe say a few words?
Okay. Rest in peace. Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
You should run some water.
Here's an idea.
It's my shirt, you know.
You want to get married?
My parents flow me some money every couple months.
That could pay for our marriage certificate. Do you have any savings?
Don't worry, I'll buy you a big old ring.
I guess I could go back to waitressing.
Yeah. Yeah, that'd be good.
Morning, sir.
Morning. I hate to bother you, but your wife came by. Said you murdered a man?
I mean, it was perfect. Down to my damn underwear, a glass of whiskey in my hand. I just looked at him and I said, I wouldn't call it murder. I realize now. That was a slip. Never easy to know what to say in the moment, is it? You know, there is one last thing that I remember. So all the dogs in town that were barking at us and we arrived that first night, not knowing what we were getting into, that I would murder a man, manslaughter a dog, and fall in love. Despite what you may think. Those fucking dogs. They would not stop barking. What do you think that means?
Some character will complain that his nowhere life is everyone else's fault. All you have to do is sit on the wrong stool. To get the good stories, you have to make an effort. You have to live them.